We're going to try to go ahead and get started. I'm Scott Whitaker. I'm the town manager in Summerfield. And we've got a brief presentation for you. They can join us. They're on their way. So we got a brief presentation for you this evening about Bandera Farms, the master plan, and part of the grant. And there's going to be a presentation by the Piedmont Land Conservancy. And then we just want to hear from you after that. It's going to be real informal, but we really want to hear from you and pass that information along. And then, in addition to that, there's a town council meeting next Tuesday night at the community center. It'll be streamed on Facebook, and there is an opportunity to come one at a time or send in comments about anything. One of the big topics is going to be Bandera Farms, the very same thing, the master plan and the part of the grant. And so, as to not delay us, I'm just going to recognize staff at PLC, Piedmont Land Conservancy, and y'all can introduce yourselves and start, and then we'll jump in to feedback.
Hey, I'm Kevin Redding. I'm the director of Piedmont Land Conservancy. We bought this property December. And very pleased to participate in this process. So we own it now. We're grateful for Summerfield and Oak Ridge and the City of Greensboro and Guilford County for helping us fund it. And now Palmer McIntyre will speak next and do the presentation to talk more about what our actual plans are. So it's a week night. We appreciate you coming out and sharing your time with us. We look forward to hearing what you've got to say. But what we're really excited about is this park becoming open to the public and becoming a real asset for your community. So thanks again for coming out. Paul?
Thanks, Kevin. Hi, everybody. Thanks for being here. I'm going to go through a presentation about the property and about the project itself and what we're talking about here. How many of y'all have been paying attention to the news about Bandera Farms? Some of you know a little bit about what, and who's here? Like, I've never heard of this. I have no idea what's going on. I'd like to know something. All right, well, great. Well, thanks. Hopefully you'll leave here tonight with a lot of more. Is it okay if I just talk without the mask? You know, you're better. Hopefully you'll leave tonight with a good background of what's going on. We want to be able to answer your questions and make sure.
Palmer, would you like to have the light on?
Maybe so, yeah. That might be good. So the presentation is about 20 minutes. So we're just going to talk about the overall project, look at the regional context, dig down to an analysis of the property itself, talk about what we've done with public engagement to this point, and talk about what kind of trails we're envisioning for this property, and then we have this master plan that we would like you to ask questions about and get some feedback on. And this, as Scott said, this is a plan. It's been a planning process for this piece of property that we bought to envision the future use of it as a community park and trails preserve with a focus on equestrian trails. And we want to leverage the money that was used to purchase the property, which was all local government money, the four jurisdictions of Summerfield, Oak Ridge, Guilford County, and the City of Greensboro. Piedmont Land Conservancy is the nonprofit partner received a state grant. We want to leverage all that money with some other state funds to help develop the property for its future uses. And so this is what part of it is. It's the Parks and Recreation Trust Fund of North Carolina. It's a pot of money that communities across the state can apply for funding to develop their parks. And Summerfield's gotten two part of grants in the past, although it's been quite a while since I think we've had the last one. So this is just a picture of the partnership, and this is the first time y'all that these entities have worked together on a project. And here we are all in the same county. It's the first time we've gotten everyone to be on board with this. So that's an exciting progress just for that part of it. And the steering committee for this whole project has been a lot of staff in these communities, and you know, we're the nonprofit partner bringing in some folks. So everyone has had a role in this process since we started it. So here is the regional context. This is the property, Bandera Farms in red. You see the new interstate. it here a number of years ago, or a few years ago, and then this other left, other piece, other side was for sale. It's on the market. It's 115 acres. Reedy Fork Creek is the boundary on this long, side here, and the interstate is the boundary here. City of Greensboro property is on the east side of it, and Bunch Road is on the west side of it. So the very edge of the town of Summerfield's jurisdiction. So the border of Oak Ridge is just across the road, and then Guilford County's jurisdiction is right there as well. So the property, the reason why we felt like it was an important investment in open space preservation is that it protects water quality. Reedy Fork Creek flows into the lakes. That's Greensboro's watershed supply. It provides a critical link for the planned Piedmont Greenway. And the Piedmont Greenway is a planned greenway that will connect Greensboro to Winston-Salem through Triad Park. And for the Guilford County area of that, it will follow Reedy Fork Creek generally. And so this is a critical piece along that Reedy Fork Creek corridor, and it's already contiguous to public parking. So it just extends that and protects that greenway corridor for us. And it also provides great open space and a good location for an equestrian park. So what's our vision? It's our vision to develop the Piedmont Greenway on this property, develop an exceptional equestrian park, and an open space resource that's got something for everyone there, for the whole community. So looking at the region itself, again, this is the same map, but just blown out a little bit more. The green line is the Piedmont Greenway line. Salem Lake Trail system there. It also can connect into the Mountains to Sea Trail and help pull the Mountains to Sea Trail off of roads. Right now it's all on roads in Summerfield. So it comes down through the Oak Ridge and then it can come down here and it can be a part of the Piedmont Greenway. So it's part of the MST route and part of the Piedmont Greenway route. And as I said earlier, we did a feasibility study back in 2018. Recommend following the Reedy Fork Creek through Bandera Farms and developing a trailhead for the Piedmont Greenway on the Bandera Farms property. And the Piedmont Greenway will connect into other trail systems, all the watershed trails around the lakes, the Bicentennial Greenway that connects down the High Point, and then of course the AMY, which is right in Summerfield's area. So there are some equestrian trail opportunities in the area, but we have always thought about equestrian trails from Bandera for a number of reasons. One is that this area has always had horses. In fact, Guilford County had the highest concentration, one of the highest concentrations of horses in all of North Carolina as recently as 2016. I don't know the current data, but it's a rich place for horse history. And so it just seems appropriate to have a horse facility in this part of the county. But there are some other facilities around. We've got some of the state parks, Stone Mountain, Private Mountain, Hang Rock. And in Guilford County, the county does have two facilities at Bryan Park, north off Doggett Road, and then at Northeast Park. Cedar Rock Park and Alamance County has some as well. But there was just a lot of interest in this part of the county to have some more horse trails, given the history of it. And what we want to do at Bandera Farms is develop purpose-built equestrian trails. So a lot of equestrian trails and some of these other places use old logging roads. We want to get away from that so that we can make sure these trails are built really sustainably and that can manage the impact of horses on them, and so there's less maintenance down the road. So taking a look at the site itself, again, you can see that you can orient on the map here. There's the interstate, Bunch Road is this road right here, and this is the property. So there's some slopes up coming off Bunch Road, but we have designed some parking areas that are consistent with those slopes. The Piedmont Greenway route basically follows the floodplain along the creek. And then you've got some really neat high open knobs. And this is some of the highest elevations in Guilford County. It's kind of cool when you get up there. You can really see a long way. It's quite beautiful, actually. So we want to take advantage of that. Just take advantage of the rolling topography. There are some constraints. There is a very narrow opening on Bunch Road that we have access to, just because of the highway and the property lines. So there is some, again, the slopes here, there's some constraints with room for trail parking, but we made it work. There's young, dense, successional forests all over the property because it was logged pretty severely right before they sold it. And there's old dirt roads that are in very poor condition, so again, we want to make the trail lines that are on those dirt roads. And there's some drainage issues as well, which you can see off Old Farm Country. So taking a look at the community engagement, the community piece that was formed, how we want to develop this property, well, the town of Summerfield has just gone through an open space and parks and trails master planning process, and the recreational needs survey really pointed to the fact that the people of Summerfield want more open space, and the people of Summerfield want more trails and greenways in their community. Really high percentages and high interest of those categories. So it was trails are the most popular facilities respondents believe that Summerfield should plan for over the next 12 years. 85% supported more sidewalks, trails, and greenways, and 70% felt more open spaces needed. We also did an equestrian rider survey that we distributed out through social media. We got 190 respondents to that, and we collected information about what types of features and what kinds of trail the equestrian community was most interested in. And you know, one of the questions we asked was, travel to ride your horses on a public or private trail system, what's the ideal number of miles? If 5 to 10 was the most popular answer, you know, even longer is good too. And then, you know, how far do you typically travel, like, you know, how many miles? And then it's how many or 40 go. And, you know, most people will drive 60 to 90 minutes, but it probably depends on how long that trail system is that they're going to. We asked about what kinds of amenities people like. Restrooms are very popular, water for horses, pull-through parking was definitely preferred. Mounting blocks are something people talk about. And then loops are nice because you're kind of seeing something different. And then the width of the trails, the types of ups and downs, that kind of thing. So all this information helped inform the design of the plan. And these are just some comments we got from folks through that survey that there was a lot of excitement about the opportunity. So we also had a number of meetings with our steering committee, again, as part of that public process where you're trying to be transparent, and looked at different options for the parking area. We settled on one final version of it that I'll show you in just a second. And when we talk about trails, so we talked about two trails on this property, Piedmont Greenway and horse trails. So the greenway would be a typical asphalt path that you have for greenways, like the AMYs. So 10 to 12 feet wide, and a shoulder on each side. And in some places, we'll have to use a boardwalk where it's really wet. But that's the plan for the greenway. But then the natural surface trail system will be 6 feet wide. And it will be a, you know, your natural surface, a dirt surface. Except in one area, there was an identified place, a turnpike, that's an elevated natural surface trail just because of the topography of the wetness. So this is just some pictures of examples of type of trails. The turnpike area, you can see typical greenway, boardwalk area, and then just a standard equestrian trail, natural surface trail. So our key planning areas are the parking area, which is A by Bench Road, B, the Piedmont Greenway Corridor, and C, which is the natural surface trail network. So taking a look at the trailhead, this is the plan that we have decided on, including the constraints and the opportunities of the property itself. Separate parking areas for cars and horse trailers was a big thing. And so you pull in off Lunch Road through the driveway, and you could have gated closures, particularly for the horse trails, because when it rains, you want to be able to close those trails and make sure they're managed appropriately. So that's why there's a roundabout, there's a steep hill that comes down here, so that's why this road goes this way, and then there's a roundabout here that if the trailer pulls in and finds the gates closed, they can safely pull back out and exit the property. And then the car parking is all there on the left. We're going to take a look at both these parking facilities, ADA compliant in each one. So the car parking, again, it's designed to be a major trailhead for the Piedmont Greenway. Think about that long-term big project, so it's been planned for 60 car spots with a drop-off loop and then a restroom and picnic shelter, as well as an adventure playscape. An adventure playscape is something that folks in the area have also indicated interest in based on recreational needs surveys and overage as well. So it's a slight, kind of a different type. you might expect, the restroom, picnic shelter, an entry gate, and the playground facilities. And then the equestrian access would have an asphalt drive aisles, 12 gravel pull-through parking spots, and then ADA parking as well, a single stall vault restroom, a water spigot for horses, and a mounting block, ADA accessible as well as typical mounting blocks. There is an option to put a little paddock at the top that was space that couldn't be used for additional parking. And these are just get some pictures of the way you might expect. The parking spots would just be designed with these simple bollards in the ground. Mounting blocks there, or should we get signs? We need signs just to indicate or to talk about the rules and respect for the trail and that such. So this is the plan for the trail system. The equestrian trail is about 4.5 miles. We added the little connectors. And so there's two loops. There's a red loop and a yellow loop with a bridge that goes across a tributary that connects the two loops. And then the Piedmont Greenway is the yellow line that's coming off of the car parking lot. So there's a focus on just the Piedmont Greenway section. So the Piedmont Greenway would be for bicyclists, runners, walkers. The horse trail system would be for just hikers and horses. No bikes, no mountain bikes at all. There's a 5% overall average trail grade on all these trails. There's a to the bridge. Again, just purpose built. I want to focus on that word. So this can be done in phases. So developing the trailhead that's more simple in the natural surface trail system. And then you can do additional trailhead elements. And then finally do the Piedmont Greenway once we did identify all the funding. So the overall goals of this project is, again, to add to the quality of life of the community, create amenity that everyone can enjoy, contribute to the health and wellness of these communities in this part of the county, hopefully provide some beneficial economic impact and tourism development. And the other thing we want to focus on, again, is leveraging the local dollars that have already gone into it with some grant funding to help pay for the development of the infrastructure. So I do want to point out one thing. Projected costs of the plan as it's been presented to you tonight, and it is given all the line items, you know, developing all the different aspects of it, including the restrooms, the adventure playscape, building the trail using a professional trail builder, a bridge, digging a well, site furnishings, which includes all the signs and the kiosks and such, the concrete walks connecting the parking areas because it's ADA. Site prep and grading, stormwater drainage, landscaping and planting, and then contingency, and then the planning incidental. It puts you a little over $2 million. That doesn't include the land acquisition, but that's already been done. So that this is the part of the budget. This is the budget for our grant application, which shows the donation portion. So we're saying that we've already got that $575,000 value. So that is our match for this grant. We're applying for $500,000 towards this total project budget. So some other potential funding sources for this. So part of, again, it's a $500,000 cap. The Recreational Trails Program has a $150,000 cap. So we'll be submitting a grant to them. We're looking at State Water Resources Development Grant Program as well. And also we'll be looking at the Land and Water Conservation Fund, which is some federal dollars coming down. So there's some different opportunities we can look at to try and reach the funding goal. And this budget looks, I should mention, leave the side action. This budget has a lower cost, and it's broken into phases, because this is the budget that's in the master plan versus the budget that we're spending the part of. So that's, I know that's a little bit. But the raw cost to develop everything that you saw except the paved greenway is $1.793 million. The number I showed you with the other grants earlier, the other two, because it's really the low amount. We do have a survey at our website. It's piedmontland.org www.bandera.org/BanderaFarmsPark. We invite you to check that out. There's a link to the whole master plan on our website as well. So you can go study it. It's about 94 pages, but about 50 pages are the actual plan itself. The rest is appendices, so it won't take too long to go through it. But at this point, we'd love to answer any questions you have. Yes?
Could you show us on the map which part of the trail is actually going to be the Greenway part?
This yellow line is the Piedmont Greenway line.
That'll be closest to the creek. Then.
Yes, it'll be closest to the creek, and it will be a paved trail, and not for horses. We're trying to keep the horses separate from the creek.
But there will be trails for walk on that are not paved.
Correct. All of these trails will be available for walkers, as well as horses.
And there's no motorized anything.
No motorized anything, except maybe a gator that the town of Summerfield needs to go tend to some maintenance issues. Yes?
Is there something planned in here that the property is rented as well?
I don't think so. Yeah, no, because the shelter is intended to be a very small shelter. So right next to the restroom. Stop.
My property is just beside this. And before this was sold, we had terrible times with the homeless parking lot.
Oh, okay.
And that's why motorized and loudspeakers.
No, there shouldn't be any of that, I don't think.
And I didn't hear the first part of your question. Just about would there be anything motorized?
Well, I think the question was will there be any speakers or type of loud noises going on?
Oh, if nothing is in the master plan, I can't imagine anything of that nature. Again, it's about the destination playground, the greenway itself, the equestrian trails, and I think the big goal of that part is not to scare horses, right?
I'm delighted about it. I think it's a real plus for the whole area, especially people.
And where do you live, man?
I live on Brookbank Road.
On Brookbank.
Oh, okay, so just up the road and kind of behind it, so you can hear. That's how you can hear. Well, it used to be quite the party spot.
Yeah.
I may have missed this, but excluding the greenway, what is the timeline for the construction?
Well, it's dependent on funding.
Right.
So it could be a few years. If we are awarded a part of grant this year, we have 3 years to use it, to fully use it. But we need to identify all the funding before we can start developing.
And just to add